So what do you have to do to get a present round here?
Videos.
Well, your present.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What lovely words, aren't they?
Aren't we lucky, though?
Something for everyone.
I mean, really, really, really lucky, aren't we?
One and all!
Merry Christmas!
I've been looking forward to this for ages.
Well, there's no time like the present.
A video makes the perfect gift. For fans of Riverdance, there are two new videos. The real story behind the hottest show on 160 legs, Riverdance, a journey.
I think the really good stuff comes when you don't give up. It's after days and days when you think there's no more left.
From the original casting to the breathtaking performance.
We're basically at the moment trusting each other and letting it go to the last minute.
From Dublin to Broadway, the magic continues. Now see the spectacular new show live from New York. A brand new video out now. For anyone who loves cars, everything he can't do on TV.
Six of the most blood-curdling cars in the world. And a two-mile runway.
To find out which is the ultimate machine.
I feel a race coming on.
Jeremy Clarkson, Unleashed on Cars. For anyone who's ever had one of those days, the man who has one every day, Mr. Bean is back, living life on the edge. The master of disaster, the king of cock-ups, and his ever-faithful partner,
Luke Tudden,
show you how not to conduct your life. Unique material. A fantastic video. Hundreds of sticky situations. For followers of that godforsaken parish...
Funny. One moment you're here.
And the next, I suppose, you just go and shoot yourself and that's that. Anyway.
Described by the Daily Mail as quite the funniest thing on TV.
Hello. Father Dougal Maguire here. And welcome to this week's Top of the Pops.
The three wayward priests from Craggy Island are in fine form.
In at number 45 this week is Father Ted Crilly with I've Got the Power.
Done with this sort of thing.
The hilarious and irreverent Father Ted. The first series now available on two videos on the Hattrick video label. For anyone who's ever had a household argument, Game On. The story of three very different flatmates. Martin, a wimp with attitude.
Excuse me?
What?
Off my face, please.
Mandy, blonde, gorgeous, and out to tease.
Ouch! Ouch! Get off, you mad cow!
And macho man Matthew, who has some very unusual habits.
Matthew, am I correct in thinking that you're wearing my knickers?
The comedy that is anything but politically correct on these two videos of the first series on the Hattrick video label. For fans of those lovable rogues...
It's not easy being a bloke in the 1990s, you know!
Find out why and join the lads Gary and Tony and the long-suffering girls Dorothy and Deborah in the hilarious latest series on two videos.
So that's that, then. It's me, youth, John.
I think it's super that we're all growing middle-aged together.
All you need now is a cardi and some slippers. Oh, you've got some.
Right. We're going to a rave.
Men Behaving Badly, the new series. A double helping for footy fans. The definitive video of Eric Cantona. His background, his dedication, his career. Find out what motivates one of the greatest and certainly the most enigmatic footballers of all time. Cantona speaks frankly, openly, and exclusively about himself. Ryan Giggs, the living legend, a special talent. A celebration of the superstar's footballing genius and a unique insight into life away from the pitch. Ryan Giggs, filmed in action and relaxing in Florida. Get to know the real Ryan Giggs. For the body conscious amongst you...
Would you like to achieve the ideal body shape for you?
I believe there's a best possible shape for everybody, and my new Body by Design program will help you find yours. This video offers a new approach to body shaping, and it allows you to design your own exercise regime. You can reshape your body the way you want, where you want. You choose whatever's right for you, and remember, work out regularly and you'll see enormous benefits.
Rosemary Conley's new Body by Design. For anyone who enjoys a good laugh, Joe Pasquale, live and squeaky, Britain's top live comedian, star of two Royal Variety performances, has now been captured on video for the first time.
It's now time for... the Buckets of Doom! I caught German measles today. Are you not taking it in turns to laugh tonight, or what? First Gladys has a go, then he has a go, then he... And some, if you want to laugh, put your name down, we'll work out a running order, then we all get a...
And the laughter doesn't stop there.
Your standing ovation, please, for Dr. Sir Leslie Colin Paterson!
Outrageous. Excessive. Uncensored. Live and rampant, Les Paterson has a stand-up.
And big announcement! I am completely off the grog.
His first ever video. He doesn't give a 4X who he offends. For lovers of sensational music and song. Les Miserables. A spectacular performance of the world's greatest musical.
Master of all!
Featuring a star-studded cast. And a magnificent score. Filmed live at the Royal Albert Hall. Les Miserables. Fabulous titles. Something for everyone. A gift for all. Videos make the perfect gift.
Going at this pace, it's going to kill me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Joe Pasquale.
Look, it's me, yes. Good evening, music lovers. Let's rock! I saw the mouse there. Where on the stair? There on the stair, right there. A little mouse with clogs on. Well, I declare, going it's now time for some professional show business. I've got to go into hospital next week and have a mole taken off my back. Look at the size of that. Can you believe it? I've got so much to do. Look, there's I can't believe, look, look how close you all are. Look, you're so close, aren't you? You know, if anyone lets off, we know who done it, won't we? Look, you're all so bright, I can see all your... Hang on, I've got a visitor there. Ladies, you're all so bright, I can see all your... What, you love it? I bet you're begging for me, aren't you? So, ladies, he spent all day doing his hair and come out without it. So, ladies, he's not smiling. It must be difficult knowing how you're going to have it in the morning. Shall I have it that side or that swooping over? Under the arm, that'd be a lot easier down there. Well, just got a lot more face to wash than the rest of us. So, ladies, just listen to this. I woke up this morning. Well, you timed that one well, didn't you? $3 million unemployed and we've got a dickhead on the keyboard. So, ladies, I always feel sorry for the people up the back, right at the top there, because they pay slightly less money than the people down here. And all you do is look at the top of my head. So just for you, this is what I really look like. So, listen to this, listen, ladies, last week, right? Oh, hang on, it's back. Ladies, last week, right? I went to see a show in London. It was a great show. It was Jose Carreras, Placido Domingo, Luciano Pavarotti and Dal Winton, right? And it was called Three Tenors and a Nine Bob Note. So that was lovely. Because listen, I don't know if you remember. Listen. You know what really gets my goat? A shepherd. Because listen, When I was really little, right, I don't know if you remember this, you used to get animal-shaped biscuits, right? And what they were biscuits in the shape of animals with chocolate on. And they weren't real animals or nothing, they were just biscuits in the shape of animals, because it'd take a lot of chocolate to cover a real animal, wouldn't it? Well, it would, like an elephant would be like 48 barrels of chocolate, wouldn't it? Like, but a hamster would just be a cup of cocoa, but no bug would, wouldn't it? Right? And how many elephants are you going to get to a box? You're only going to get one to a box, which isn't great value, right? And realistically, how much is it going to cost? It's going to cost you about £4.50, right? And you open the box, you get one bloody elephant for £4.50, right? Unless, of course, they were Indian elephants, right? Because Indian elephants are a bit smaller than African ones, aren't they? Well, they are, because they've got smaller ears, right? And then, because African elephants got great big ones, like Dumbo. He was an African elephant. Even though he was only little, he was African, right? And the Indian elephant's got smaller ears, which is why Indian elephants never wore glasses, because they couldn't get it out of the arm, right? And it's all to do with the jeans, right? Not that I've seen an elephant wear a pair of jeans, I've never seen one. I've never watched Wildlife and One and seen David Attenborough going, yes, here we have an Indian elephant with a pair of 501s on. I've never seen it, right? And how are you going to, even if you buy a box, how are you going to get them home? Unless you've got a forklift truck or a lorry, you'd never get them home, would you, right? And even if you do get them home, how are you going to get them in the kitchen, right? You'd have to knock all of the back wall out, right, to just get the box through. It'd cost you £1,500 just to wear your bloody elephant with a pair of jeans on, right? So you might as well leave it in the car. I don't know what the bloody hell I'm talking about, do I, right? The hope, no, please, ladies and gentlemen, please. Ladies and gentlemen, please. The whole point of that story is to let you know I used to like those animal-shaped biscuits, right? And I bought myself a box once, but on the side of the box it said, do not eat contents if seal broken. So I opened the box. Have I missed the joke there? So I opened the box and I laid them all out on a big plate and wouldn't you know it, the bloody seal was broken, right? I tried to convince myself it was a walrus, but it was definitely a seal because he had a ball on his nose and he had a flat willy where he was going, oh, 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 oh. So, ladies and gentlemen, the thing is, listen, if you're ever feeling unwell, right, if you've got a cold, got the flu, a nasty rash, all you've got to do, cover yourself in margarine, go to the doctors and say, oh, I can't believe it's not better. And I personally think, no, please, ladies and gentlemen, I think the best way to smuggle drugs into this country is up a dog's bum, right? It is, because a sniffer dog's only going to sniff his bum anyway. He's got drugs up there, now he just likes having a sniff. And the only way you get caught was if the dog was sweating a lot and wore a pair of sunglasses. Okay, because listen, I've got a lovely old dog. I've got a lovely dog. I'm teaching him to meow because I think it'll help him to have a second language, right? It's going to be a bloody long night, isn't it? And the thing is, he's got this awful habit, right? He drinks water out of the toilet, which I really hate, especially while I'm sitting on it. Like. I took him to the vet, so I told him all about it. He said, I'm sorry, I've got to put him down. So I said, why? He said, my arms are aching. And I said, just as well, people go really fast on motorways, don't we? I do it, you will go fast in the motorways. Because what you do, you get in your car and you think, I'm not going to go fast, I'm not going to speed today, I'm just going to keep the speed limit, I'm going to do 70 miles an hour and no more. So you get in the car, right? You get in the car and you're doing 68 miles an hour, going, oh, 68 miles an hour, I'm not breaking the speed limit. And all of a sudden, there's a bloke doing 70 in front of him and you want to get by him. And you think, well, the only way I can do it is do 72. So you go, oh, I'll just do 72 for a couple of minutes and get past him. And you do 72, you go, oh, oh, oh. And you look around and you go, like that. And then there's a bloody another one in front of you, go like that, you go, oh. And by the time you get the end of the motor, you're doing 90 miles a bloody hour, right? All because you want to get there first, and first is no good for, because you're never there first. There's always somebody there before you get there. I wasn't bloody first, I didn't know I wasn't there. What is really good for you, right, is next. If you've never been, well, you probably have been next, but you've not consciously thought about it, right? Say you're in the post office, right, and there's six people before you, and you think, oh, I fancy a jam donut and a sausage roll, and so you wouldn't be in the post office, would you? You'd be in the bakery, because you look a bit of a div in the post office. So, can I have a donut? So you know you want the bakery, you div. Oh, lovely. So say there's like six people before you. I don't know what I'm talking about, right? There's like six people before you. I've only come out for a loaf of bread. Say there's six people, right? Six people, you go six people, bummer, right? Then it goes down to five, then it goes down to four, down to three, down to two, down to one, then you're next. And it's a great feeling, isn't it? Well, it is, isn't it? It is, you look behind, there's like 12 people, but you go, I was up there a little while ago, but I'm not now, I'm next. And it's great, because you can say to the bloke behind you, go on, you go before me, it don't matter, I'll still be next. And it's true, isn't it? It's true. Why is it wherever you go in the country, everywhere's got a post office like this? Sponsored walk to buy a stamp, right? And when you get to the end of the queue, the form you wanted is by the bloody door, isn't it, right? And I used to work in a post office, and last year I met the Queen, and the only time I'd seen her was on a stamp. So when I met her, I didn't know whether to shake her hand or lick the back of her head. It was amazing. And one day, this bloke came into the... Did anyone see the Royal Variety Show last year? I don't know if you remember, it was the same night that the Queen's mum was in hospital having her leg done, right? And right at the end of the show, Des O'Connor went, three cheers for the Queen! Hip, hip! And I went, replacement! And it just didn't go down too long. So, what's got 18 inches and speaks French? Moi! And the thing, I'm sorry. You are begging for it, though, aren't you, lovely? The thing is that, you know stamps have famous people on them, right? Well, it's all changed. On the new stamps, they've got famous prostitutes on them. And they're 20 pence each, but if you lick them, they're 45 pence! Ricky! Sorry, I turned into Mike Reed then. And one day, this bloke came in the post office, right? He had 168 stitches on his face. Well, he had a balaclava on. And he came in... Janine! And he came in, right? And he had this shotgun, and he shoved it right out my nose, right? The shotgun as well. And he looked at me. He went, see you. He was really hard. He was grimacing. He was like that. He was like... I know it doesn't look hard to you, but it feels quite hard to you. Like that. And he looked at me, right? And you know what he looked like? One of those blokes. Do you remember when you was a kid, you had a man's face on a bit of cardboard? And in front of the cardboard, his face, you'd get a bit of plastic. And in between the plastic and his face, you'd get iron filings for his hair. And you could get a magnet and take his hair off his head and put it on. He looked just like that bloke there! He's still not smiling. And he looked at me, right? He went, see you. He went, see you. He went, your geography. I said, don't you mean history? He said, don't change the subject. Can you? A bloke came straight in, straight out. He said, excuse me, can you check my balance? So I pushed him over. I said, well, you got that. So, what's your name there, sir? Where'd you come from? What you doing for a living? Too many questions all at once, isn't it? Yeah. Do you want to see my pence, then? Perhaps not. So, how much you pay for your ticket, sir? £9.50. Well, that's not... What can you do with £9.50 nowadays? Buy a wig. What else can you do with £9.50? Everything is about money. I was doing the lottery last week, right, and they was calling all the numbers out, and they had my tickets in front of me, and they went 5. I went, oh, I got it. And then they went 4. I went, oh, I got that. And then they went 3. I went, oh, I got that. And then I realised they were just doing the bloody countdown, right? Right at the end of it, there was a knock on my window, and I pulled the curtain back, and there was a big hand outside the window, and it went, I don't think it was me, because you know what's really weird? Like, people have started to recognise me now, but they don't recognise me till I open my mouth. And they go, oh, you're that squeaky voice gonk off the telly, have that. And they give me a good hiding, right? So what I've had to do, I've had to learn how to handle myself. So what I've been doing, right? I've been going to evening classes for karate lessons, right? But because I'm dyslexic, I ended up going to karaoke lessons. Which worked out to my advantage in the long run, I think you'll find, because last week I got set upon by 6 skinheads and I got through 3 verses of I Will Survive before they beat me up. Which was great, because they was all lined up in front of me and I looked at them and they looked at me and I thought, I'm going to have them before they have me. So I went for it. I went... He was with me at the time. First I was afraid. I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. I spent oh so many nights just feeling sorry for myself. I used to cry, but now I hold my head up high and you see me, oh, 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 somebody, oh, 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 I'm not that mixed up little girl. Problems. You paid £9.50 and you don't want to hear this, right? I'm going to tell you anyway, I split up with my girlfriend last week. No, it's all right, she was a dog anyway, right? And what happened? She said I was nosy. Well, she didn't say I was nosy, I read it in her diary, right? You're going to have to work a bit harder than this. And what happened, right? I read an article in Woman's Own about the language of love. And they reckon in Woman's Own, if you speak to women with a French or Italian accent, it's supposed to make them more susceptible to your manly charms. Know what I mean? I think you do. Well, I've done my own research and found out that's just cobblers, ladies and gentlemen. I found out the actual language of love is, in fact, South Vietnamese. It's true, try it out for yourself. Next time you're with the one you love, right, just lean over and gently whisper in her ear, Flo, help, oh, Big Mac. It only works if she's a pot-bellied pig, but it's worth having a go. And you know what she said? She came round my house, she said, I can't see you anymore. I said, I'm behind the settee. I know what you're all thinking. You're all thinking with that accent and the way he talks, he must be American, right? And I'm not, I come from a little village in Italy called Venice, which is lovely if you've never been there, because there's loads of places to learn to swim. And when I was three, my dad taught me, have we got any ex-servicemen in tonight? Yeah. Oh, am I facing the right way tonight? Have we, have we got any in? Brilliant, I'm looking for my dad. Is he here? He owed me 34 years of pocket money, because one day I came home from school, I'd been in the school sports day and I was in the 100 metres. And when I got home, my dad said, what position did you finish in? I said, well, it was a bit like that, you div. What do you expect, that? And he taught me how to swim, and he took me down by the water. He said, there's only one way to learn, and he just threw me in. First go, no practice, nothing. But I was like a little baby duck, I swam to the side. I had a bit of trouble getting out of the sack, but I got the side after about half an hour. And because I was first born, everything had to be done right, so I was breastfed by my granny. I had to share that with someone that smoked old Oldham, but I was breastfed, right? And being breastfed by your granny don't affect you. It didn't affect, well, I say it didn't affect me. I like my milk after the sell-by date, that's all. Count to three, wait for the laugh, then carry on. But let's just, the only jobs I had, right, I used to be a long-distance lorry driver on the Isle of Wight. The other job, right, I was a tour guide in Vatican City. I was actually inside the Vatican. And I was showing people round, and I was telling them about the Pope. And he walked round the corner, I went, oh, speak of the devil, and... That didn't last too long. Then I thought I'd have a great job at London Zoo cleaning out the animals, because no one ever cleans them out. And I thought that'd be really easy. Don't need no training, just pick it up as you go along. And one day, the zookeeper come over. He said, oi, Dippy, because he knew me quite well by then, right? He said, Dippy, you've been promoted. Our gorilla's just died. Put this costume on. £500 a week. All you got to do is go, oh, oh. But don't say nothing other than, oh, oh, oh. People know you're not a real gorilla and you get the sack. And I loved it, right? But Friday morning, 30 kids come down from school on a day's outing. Now, 29 of them were really nice. One of them was awful. His name was Colin, right? He had ginger hair, freckles, a pair of National Health glasses with a bit of plaster over one of the lenses. He had icing all over his nose where the snot had gone hard. And he was licking it. And it was all flaking off like candle wax into his sandwiches. Right? And he come right over the bars and put his hand in his pocket. I thought, what's he getting out of? Because he was so deep, he was nearly in the top of his sock. And because I had the mask on, I couldn't see, but it looked like a banger. Now, he must have lit this banger because he threw it. Now, make me jump like that. I've got a bloody ladder in my sock now. Look at the size of that. Can you... Hey? I bet you can get a bus ticket between your cheeks now. I tell you, I was... Somebody else with a visit. I was so frightened. I jumped right out the top of the cage and landed in the cage next door where there was a dirty great big lion padding about on all fours, leaving five tracks. Know what I mean? I think you do. It was his tail, so I thought, I don't care how much they're paying me, I'm going to shout, which anyone in their right mind would do, so I shouted. I went, help, let me out. And this lion jumped on my back and said, shut up or we both get the sack. And that's true, lady. That's true. Really, no, true. Really. Really. It's not necessary. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to move on because this is a very special night tonight, ladies and gentlemen, as you... More special than any of us realise, obviously. And because it's a special night, I've put something special together to do on a special night. Because if it wasn't special, then I shouldn't be doing it tonight, should I? And then if it wasn't special, this wouldn't be a special night, but... I think you'd agree with me that this is quite a special night. And what you're going to see is quite special because something I've never done before, ladies. You people tonight are going to witness the birth of a new routine. Oh, you're getting into this now, aren't you? And what it is, basically, it's a new form of entertainment that I seem to have discovered by accident in the confines of my own bedroom. And I sounds like some of you may have already discovered it, doesn't it? But if you haven't yet discovered it, I think once it hits the streets, everybody will be doing it. And I can't say it's called this, ladies and gentlemen. I can't say it's called that. I can't say it's called anything yet. It's not called nothing yet because we haven't done it before. But it's something special. That's what it is, ladies and gentlemen. And I hope you're going to enjoy it because I spent a lot of time rehearsing it and I think you're going to enjoy it. I think you'll enjoy it that much. And when you get home tonight, you'll go and go, what a lovely new form of entertainment that was. We was witness to something special there. So, Liz, I won't be doing this alone. I'd like to introduce you now to my dancing partner and also my twin brother, Reynard. Reynard, would you like to enter the stage arena area now, please? Reynard, would you like to enter the stage arena area now, please? Reynard? As you can see, we're not identical twins, ladies. As we were split up at birth, and Reynard was brought up by a family of ninja mullet in the Aegean Sea. And it was only for Scylla Black going on holiday to Greece, scuba diving, and seeing him there swimming about with the ninja mullet going, whoa, 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 and brought us together on surprise, surprise. You're all right, all right. Like a punch in the mouth, sir. I don't think you find we have got the same nose. But after I've punched you, your nose would be very similar, wouldn't it? See that lady there, Reynard, in the black? She wants you. Better than HRT, eh, love? You really are a stud monkey, aren't you? Reynard, come on, that's enough. That's enough now. No, you get yourself up. You get yourself in that position, you get yourself out of it. And that's your starting position there. That's it there. Reynard, that's where we start, over there. Yes, dear. Solvite, okay? Don't give me any of your old flannel. Get over there now. I've got to be honest, I can't stand the sight of him. I don't want to be anywhere near him, but you never know when you're going to need a kidney, do you, ladies and gents? He's an ugly sod, though, isn't he? Let's be honest. If beauty skin deep is inside out! Reynard? £9.50 for that, eh? So please enter my world of magic and illusion, a world into the towels of the unexpected. Yes, leave it, you're getting on my nerves. Yes, ladies and gents, there are things in this world we will never understand. Do you realise we only use 20% of our brain power? The other 60% lays dormant. Judging on that reaction, some of us don't even use 20%. Things need to be answered, like which hand is the frog in? It's that one, because he's dead, yes? Where's the dipstick in a Skoda? In the driving seat. Hands up all the Skoda drivers. Well, they won't be here till tomorrow, will they? Leave it. Why is it when you go to a police station it has pictures of wanted men on the wall? Why don't they keep hold of them when they took their bloody pictures? Who was the first person to discover you could get milk from a cow? And what did he really think he was doing at the time? Oh, there's some chitty things hanging under that cap. I'm going to have a bash on them. Oh, it must be milk. Yeah, right, whatever. It's now time, ladies and gentlemen, for the mystery of the linking rings. And as you can see, these rings are already linked, so that's going to save us a lot of time. Now, a trick that Paul Daniels can't do. It'll come back to you again, don't it? So, can I have some magic music, please, boys? Is entitled Spooks Alive. Grow up, for God's sake. I'm having a party in my pants and you're all invited. sitting there. Ladies, I'm a really good impressionist as well, so I'm going to ask that really nice lady there. What's your name, you hot, sexy mama? Yes, as you usually tell. What's your name, dear? What's your name? And have you got a handkerchief? No, can you borrow one? You got something hanging just there. And you thought, look, I'm looking, you have a big Gilbert. Okay, and who's your favourite film star, you hot piece of totty? Because whoever it is, I'll be able to do an impression of anyone you like. Patrick Swayze. Who's your second favourite, Anne? Most impressionists do an impression of Robert Mitchum, right? But not me for Anne tonight, because I find her strangely attractive. But I'm on heavy medication, so it don't count over Anne. My world-famous impression of Robert Mitchum's dad for Anne. Can I have some Robert Mitchum's dad's music for Anne? Films on telly, they all have macho names like Clint and Tex and Butch. They never have real names. Picture this, a spaghetti western with real names. This is what it would sound like. Hit it, Kermit, go. Okay, go for your gun, Malcolm. It sounds stupid. It's like, oh, you shot me, Kevin. Sorry, Nigel. It's ridiculous. Why did the Mexican throw his wife off the cliff? Tequila! Hold it one bloody minute! Who shouted tequila? I won't bloody have this on the video, okay, love? Don't think I won't hit you, because I will. I will come down and spank you so hard, love! You're thinking, love. And don't you lean out of the way either. So many people are going to see you make a big div of yourself on this, aren't they? You're thinking to yourself, has he told five jokes? Or six? Because I've got a joke that will take your head clean off of your shoulders. You could ask yourself a question there, love. Do you feel funny? I don't think you do, do you? So, you know, in this business, right, we all have our favourite entertainers and people we like to look up to. And everybody does in every walk of life. And I've got my favourite entertainer. And my favourite one, right, is Stevie Wonder. And last year, I went to see him perform live at Wembley Stadium. And he cost me 48 quid a ticket. And I was so far back, I could hardly see anything. But for you people tonight, I'm going to reenact for you what it was like to watch Stevie Wonder live from the back of Wembley Stadium. Here, lads, let's do it.
Thank you for the voltage you gave to me. Sunny, thank you for the love you gave to me.
That's funny, isn't it? Oh, God. It's funny, isn't it? Look. So, it looks like him, doesn't it? So, ladies and gentlemen. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's Ned. He doesn't know what way he's facing, does he, Ned? So, ladies and gentlemen, it's Ned time. Spanish Nechan. We still don't know no different. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Nechan for my tribute to Mr. Johnny Mathis. Thanks, Johnny. I woke up this morning and I had to... I can't believe you remember. Okay, I forgot. So, I woke up this morning and I... So what, you decided to make a joke out of it now, have you? On this special night, because you missed it the first time, you thought you'd get it in twice later. Is that what it is? No. You monkey spankers. Great timing for the cough, sir. Would you all like to have a cough? All right, don't milk it then. You're regretting that near as I'm standing here looking at you, aren't you? You fat bloke. So, there's two words you should learn. I'm full. So, no, don't hit me, I've got a bad stomach trouble. No guts. So, I woke up this morning. That's a funny way to hand your notice in, isn't it? Once I rose from my slumber this AM, I looked down and I noticed that my big toe had gone. And when I looked down again, there was a note with... There was a note where the big toe should have been. And you know what the note said? Gone to market. I didn't think you was going to get that, but you did, didn't you? I know there's certain things this evening you haven't got yet, but don't worry, when you get home tonight, you'll just be dozing off and you go, oh, I got it! And that'll be... Always remember that laughter is the best medicine. Unless you're a diabetic, then insulin works better, I think. It's no good going into a coma and someone saying, have you heard the one about two Irish? When it's not, you go, oh! It's not going to help, really, is it? It's not. I had to go to the doctor. I went to the doctor, said, doctor, whenever I poke in this titty here, that really hurts. And if I poke in that titty, that really hurts as well. But if I poke in my belly button like that, that really hurts. He said, can I have a go? Which I thought was a strange request. But I said, help yourself, because that's the sort of bloke I am. Help yourself. He said, OK, I will. Mm-hmm. And he went, does that hurt? I said, no. He said, what about that? I said, no. He said, what about that? I said, no. He said, you've broken your finger then. See him there, Bubba Papa on the drums. Last week, he got set upon by an agoraphobic skinhead. Have you ever heard of an agoraphobic skinhead? He went, oi, you, inside now. Last week, no, it was about a year ago, I saw a friend of mine called Billy O'Donoghue. I've not seen him for 24 years since I was at junior school. And he was walking towards me. He hadn't changed a bit in 24 years. It was still the same Billy O'Donoghue I knew. And he was walking towards me. I ran over and I went, Billy O'Donoghue, 24 years since I've seen you. How the devil are you? And I slapped him on the back. And as I slapped him on the back, he fell on the floor and started to cry. And that was when I realised if that really was Billy O'Donoghue, he'd be the same age as me now. Don't try and think about that one there, it will come naturally later. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. It's near time for my tribute to one of the most greatly and naturally talented vocalisers the known world has ever known. My tribute to that lovely man with a lovely voice. No, I'm okay for a minute. It's not a double act, is it? He didn't say, please welcome Joe Pasquale and some spam head in the front row, did he? I don't think he did. You're not going to buy one of these videos, are you? My tribute in a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that's a good one. I'll save it. My tribute, ladies and gentlemen. No, look. You really don't get out enough, do you? Ladies and gentlemen, my tribute to that lovely man, Mr. Johnny Mathis. With music for the millions. A ray of hope flickers in the sky. A tiny star lights up way up high. All across the land dawns a brand new morn. This comes to pass when a child is born. What lovely words, aren't they? Ha, 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 ha. Anyway. Just not turned out to be my special night, really, is it? Yeah, like you really mean it. Ha ha, bloody hell! Dracula has got no reflection. How come he always had such a straight parting in his hair? Called German measles today. taking it in turns to laugh tonight, or what? First Gladys has a go, then he has a go, then he... And some, if you want to laugh, put your name down, we'll work out a running order, then we all get a go. Look, I'm trying to grow a beard at the moment. That's coming on nicely, ain't it? Look. I can't believe how careless people are. I found this by a hole in the road. I could have tripped over it and fallen down the bloody hole. What's that all about? This bloke is getting up my nose. You know he's there, but you mustn't look at him, do you know what I mean? You feel like someone's looking at you all the time. You're going, who's there? This is just for the benefit of people at home watching in 3D glasses. Sort that one out, smart ass. So, what was that? Oh, look at this one, look. See that? Look at that. Look, look. It's a capon. This is a toilet seat for people who are constipated and spend a long time on the toilet. Look. That's Jerry and the pacemakers. Brown girl in the ring. La 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 la. There's your brain. I don't think I need to say any more for that one, do I? I started writing poetry today. That's coming on nicely, ain't it? This is a coat hanger for men. There's no hook on it because it always ends up on the floor anyway. Dinner, 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 Batman! Batman. I don't know if anyone's ever been to a McDonald's drive-thru, right? But you drive up to the speaker and a woman's voice comes out and goes, oh, 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 oh. And you go, what? I can't understand the word you're saying. You go, I can't understand that. I'll give you my order. I'll have 2 Big Macs, 2 French fries and an apple pie to burn my mouth with. And she says, and you go, is that what I ordered? I don't bloody know. And rather than make yourself look an idiot, you go, yes, that's what I ordered. Well, this is a great weapon in the war against McDonald's drive-thrus. Drive up to the speaker with one of these and go, and you'll end up with a gearbox for a Mark III Cortina. Neighbourhood watch area. I stole this to prove a point. Now, that's what I call a pair of silicone implants. It's a briefcase. What, you're getting fussy all of a sudden, are we? Look out there. This is Shakespeare. Look, that's Hamlet. I'm going to do a scene there from a film by Alfred Hitchcock. Now, I'm not going to tell you what the film is. You've got to guess. Wait, I ain't bloody done it yet. You've got to guess what the film is. Here it comes, here it comes, here it comes. That's right, Psycho. I made that. look, I bought a new bum bag as well. That's quite nice. Not checked the pockets, could be a packet in there. Look at the head on that. Skull lager. When I was 6 years old, I joined an artist group and had to draw a picture of a pig, and that was the picture. And when the teacher came along, he said, "What's that?" I said, "That's my pig." He said, "No, it's the wrong shape. Pigs look round." So, well, so does this one. Smart ass, look. Here's something you don't see very often. Snap! See that very often, do you? No. 10:20. Diet Coke break. On me hair. Not as funny as when it fell off, really, was it? It's a tuna fish. Look, see this, look. This is my step ladder. My real ladder left home when I was 3 years old. Yes, I never found out what that bloke's... What's your name there, sir? Steve, have you got a mobile phone, Steve? You have, sir, have I? Look, I made myself one just for me and you, because I knew you was coming to me. Just for me. That one's for you, Steve. Sit down, mate. Okay, lean back. I said, not too much, you pull me bloody arm. Okay. Shall we rock? Let's rock. No, in time, you dopey sod, didn't you? That's it. We look like Rosie and Jim there, don't we? OK, now, what do you have to do with this? Have you used one of these before, Steve? No, you liar. What do you have to do? Oh, OK, that's enough rocking there. What do you have to do? One of you has to put it out here, and one of you has to put it in mouth. What would you like, your ear or your mouth? Obviously, you've heard that question before, Steve, haven't you? What would you like, your ear? You go for the ear, and I'll talk to you first. Hello, Steve. Oh, you heard it. Brilliant. Works, doesn't it? Works. OK, I say to you again. My turn again. I've got to talk. I'll put you here. I'll talk to you now, OK? And what I'm going to say is very personal and private between me and you. I don't want no one else to hear. I love you, Steve. You'll go, Steve, and just be honest with yourself. Hang on, Steve, I've got to put you on hold. I've got another call coming. Hello? Oh, ladies, a round of applause for Steve. Thank you, sir. Can I have my phone back? Thank you. Who's that lady there? Is that your wife sitting next to you there, or just a friend of the kids? That's your wife. What's your name, you foxy mama? What is it? Tanya. Nice dress, Kay's catalogue, page 48, isn't it? 48 weeks, 50p a week. I've got a new aftershave on, Tanya. Have a sniff. Do you know what that's called? No, tester. Just see if he's still going. Les, you've been really nice tonight. You've been a challenge. And you've won. But what I'm going to do... No, it's been lovely. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to leave you now with a lovely song for a lovely lady, Tanya. But it's not you. And the song... No, it's not. It's for you, Tanya. Have you ever been on the Love Boat, Tanya? Well, I'm going to take you a cruise in, baby. Thanks, Montego. Metro? Maestro. Oh, what kind of fool am I, who never fell in love? Are you in the right key? The only one that I've been thinking of. What kind of... I bet you're all imagining me nude now, aren't you? I look like Brad Pitt, don't I? Oh, his brother says. What kind of
clown? Oh! 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 Oh!
I bet you want me there, don't you, Tanya? Come on, you foxy mama, get your kit off. You know you want me. I'm hung like a hamster and you're gagging for it. Get those surgical stockings off and round my neck, you dirty little mama. You dirty, dirty. I'm just feeling run down tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, you have been really nice this evening, but I'm going to be honest, I did want to finish tonight on a standing ovation. Well, you've obviously made your minds up this evening, haven't you? But I don't want to force you. All you need is a bit of pressure at the top of the legs, and up you go! But it's entirely your decision, and I don't want to change your minds if it's been made up. Leave it, no buggers moving. Ladies and gentlemen, from me, good night, God bless. Thank you very much for coming tonight. See you then soon. sorry, Tony, I've made you all wet now. Not before time, though, eh, Steve? Ladies and gents, please, a nice round of applause for our musicians, Billy Millett and his dancing chickweed, Mr. Mickey Hewitt, and Wally Lobster Webster. Ladies and gentlemen, it's near time, ladies and gentlemen, for something deadly dangerous. Tonight, I will be tweaking the nipples of fear. I laugh in the face of danger. Ah, ha, ha, ha. Sometimes I scare myself. Ah! But not then, because I knew it was coming. And people used to call me stupid. As well as no neck and chum breath, but lose it. It's now time for... the Buckets of Doom! Oh! That's a funny bloody way to hand your notice in, isn't it? I'm okay. Do I look okay? That's okay. You have been really nice tonight. A lot of people say to me afterwards, they come up and go, excuse me, that was cack. And I'll go, oh, no. It's 10p, go and phone somebody that gives the monkeys, because I really don't. I think there's too many bad things going on in the world. If you can't come out and have a little cack every now and then, there's something wrong with us. But I know it's cost you £9.50, but hey. Basically, I'm trying to say thanks for coming, because if you hadn't come, there'd be nobody ever done. None of this is my fault. It's not none of this is my fault. My dad was cranky, right? When I was really little, he used to sit me on his knee and tell me stories. He'd throw me in the air and walk away. And I used to have braces on me teeth. And when we went out, he'd put fridge magnets on them for a laugh. I'd be out playing football in the streets with my mates and he'd come out and he'd go, Joseph, come in and have your tea. I'd go, Dad, I'm playing football. He'd go, oh, And he'd go in. And then he'd be out 5 minutes later, he'd go, Joseph, come in and have your tea. I'd go, Dad, I'm still playing football. And he'd go, And go in. And he'd come out a third time and he'd say, if you don't come in and have your tea, I'm going to kill your pet turtle. And I loved my pet turtle because I made him myself. I just got an empty tortoise shell and wrapped it round a chihuahua. He was the fastest turtle alive. I was made to look at things, watch things. I'm subjected to things that no 28-year-old should have seen. He'd drag me in the kitchen and he'd get a housefly and hold it above a toy globe of the world and watch him go, oh, I've gone too high. But as he took with this end, he'd take with the other as well. Then he'd headbutt me. But he was good to me as well. He used to give me little handy tips, you know. He used to say things like, if you want to keep monkeys out your bedroom, keep bananas in your kitchen. If you look like your passport photo, you're too ill to travel. Oh, no, song that'll get on your nerves, get on your nerves, get on your nerves. Come on, now. Get on your nerves, get on your nerves. This side on your arm, now, no, song that'll... Yeah, get down. Wind your body and bogle. Get on. Now this side, go. Oh, no, song that... Yeah, get down, get funky. Shabba. They're just a slap edge on his own. Oh, no, it's on that. Get on. Get on. Get on. Oh, no. Get on. Get. Leave it. It's getting on my nerves now. Ladies and gentlemen, from me, good night. God bless. Thank you very much for coming tonight. See you again.